Hello, I hope you all are safe and healthy. I'm Prashant Ravi, a wedding photographer and an entrepreneur hailing from Chennai. So today, here I am with the brand new Canon EOS R5 camera, which has been talk of the town for a while. Destination shoots are my absolute favorite. I'm very excited to show you guys the real-time results of R5. Here you go.
Hi.
Hi.
So my name is Rebecca.
My name is Gautam.
So we're here for our couple shoot and we are pretty much very excited about it. Are you?
Yes, I am.
First to talk about is the ergonomics of R5. It feels so good, pretty similar build to my previous EOS R camera, wherein I missed the AF control joystick and the scroll wheel dial. Its addition now is much welcomed. Also, I should not forget to mention about the flip screen. It's a savior to my backbone pain when shooting at such lower angles in many of my shoots. Initially, few shots were like warm up for me. Now moving on to the image quality. A 45 MP CMOS sensor is almost near to a medium camera format range. I shot few images against the natural lights and also used some external lights to test its dynamic range in post-processing. You can look at these before and after results. Auto-focusing. Here I am testing few more shots having a spillover of water in the foreground to test its autofocusing capabilities. I must say it nailed every time it locked the focus onto the subject without shifting its focus back even when there was a disturbance in the foreground. And then I shot few images of the couple with the bicycle. This time I enabled the eye detection to people to see how the autofocusing system performs. As the couple approached towards the camera, it tracked the eyes perfectly almost in all the shots. That's incredible. Dual pixel CMOS AF2 technology is now the current leader of the class. This feature improvisation is the most exciting one for me to freeze the right moment with accurate focus on point. Later, we moved on to a beautiful interior to shoot some intimate portraits. With varied RF lenses, I shot a couple of different images at the same place. Now it's speed. The speed of 20 frames per second with electronic shutter and 12 frames per second with mechanical shutter is again a great bonus.
Action. Nice.
Look here, with great focusing and incredible speed, I can get the best out of everything I shoot. Before I talk about the new IBIS and also the video quality, have a look at this 1 minute video I managed to shoot in between the photo shoot. All the footages are shot at 4K, 60 frames per second handheld. Thank you. I hope you like the video. And to my surprise, it takes the helm as the best full frame stabilization system on the market to date, up to 8 stops. With the digital IS and lens IS switched on, my clips looked as if it doesn't need any external accessories for stabilization. With IBIS, no crop and eye tracking at 4K resolution, that's a huge step for a camera that shoots high quality images as well. So yeah, lastly at the late evening, I really wanted to test the low light performance of the camera. As a native ISO, range up to 51,200, remarkable image quality were achievable at higher ISO with lesser noise. So I set my ISO somewhere around 6,400 to 8,000 and I was really surprised to see the results. So yeah, what are my final thoughts here? This is an incredible camera for photographers like me who shoot both photos and videos on the go. And also it's a great deal for a generation that's slowly marching towards filmmaking in 4K resolution.